ബെൽറ്റു.
I can't believe this. Life is crazy. It's an incredible turn from sweet imaginations to wild thoughts of death. There is darkness outside, and my life too is full of darkness now. I sense the end of everything. I feel it's all over. I'm scared.
Oh no, the fun mode is off. Didn't you see? Our homeopath is in danger. He turned around when he heard the sound. He was startled to see a fat snake wriggling up the chair. Kaseravari oru thadiyan moorkan paambu. It coiled itself around his left arm. I can't imagine. Our doctor has become motionless. He can't even cry out for help. The snake has spread its hood as though ready for an attack. What will happen now? But wait, have you completed your assignment? The thoughts of the homeopath? Good children, let me show you the work posted by one of my students. Take a look.
Wow, what a handsome look. But there is something incomplete. Something which is really missing. I think it's my hairstyle. From today onwards, I'll take a neat parting with comb and make my hair look straight and neat. That's going to add on to my handsome look. But what if I grow a thin mustache? Maybe that will give me a pleasant look. So henceforth, this is an important decision that I'm going to shave daily and grow a thin mustache for the betterment of my appearance. Oh my goodness! Look at my smile! It's so attractive. People like me are so lucky enough to be blessed with such an attractive smile. Now, this is for sure. I'm going to keep that attractive smile on my face always because I want to make my presence felt before the world. After all, I'm a bachelor and a doctor. But then, I can't remain a bachelor always. I will have to find someone to walk the path of life with me. A rich lady doctor would be the right choice for me. But then my wife has to be fat. Even if she's not stunningly attractive as me, she must definitely be fat because if I made a silly mistake and needed to run away, she should not be able to run after me and catch me. Now, that's so cool.
Great. Let's move on with the story. Take a look at the recap.
He sat down on the chair. There was a large mirror on the table. He looked into the mirror. He decided to shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. He smiled while looking into the mirror. It was a charming smile. He also decided to wear the charming smile on his face to look more handsome. A lovely thought came to his mind. He would marry a rich lady doctor. His wife must be so fat that when he committed any mistake and needed to run away, she might not be able to catch him. While on his chair, he heard a thud. Before he could understand anything, a fat snake wriggled over the back of the chair and landed on his shoulder. Then it slid from his shoulder and coiled round his left arm above the elbow.
That's really so scary. A snake on the shoulder? What could he do now? Who can get over such a situation? The doctor was dreaming about his future, about his marriage. It was fun. But the snake has switched off the fun mode. It's fear factor dominating the scene now. എത്ര നല്ല നല്ല സ്വപ്നങ്ങളായിരുന്നു മനസ്സിൽ. മനോഹരമായ ചിന്തകളെല്ലാം അവസാനിച്ചു. വാട്ട് നെക്സ്റ്റ്? ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ലെറ്റ്സ് റീഡ് ദ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഫൈൻഡ് ഔട്ട്.
ഐ ഡിഡ്ന്റ് ജമ്പ്, ഐ ഡിഡ്ന്റ് ട്രംപിൾ, ഐ ഡിഡ്ന്റ് ക്രൈ ഔട്ട്. There was no time to do any such a thing. The snake slithered along my shoulder and coiled around my left arm above the elbow. The hood was spread out and its head was hardly 3 or 4 inches from my face. It would not be correct to say merely that I sat there holding my breath. I was turned to stone. But my mind was very active. The door opened into darkness. The room was filled with darkness. In the light of the lamp, I sat there like a stone image in the flesh. I felt then the great presence of the creator of this world and this universe. God was there. Suppose I said something and he did not like it. I tried in my imagination to write in bright letters outside my little heart the words, "Oh God." There was some pain in my left arm. It was as if a thick leaden rod, no, a rod made of molten fire, was slowly but powerfully crushing my arm. The arm was beginning to be drained of all strength. What could I do? At my slightest movement, the snake would strike me. Death lurked 4 inches away. Suppose it struck. What was the medicine I had to take? There were no medicines in the room. I was but a poor, foolish and stupid doctor. I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. It seemed as if God appreciated that. The snake turned its head. It looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. I do not claim that it was the first snake that had ever looked into a mirror. But it was certain that the snake was looking into the mirror. Was it admiring its own beauty? Was it trying to make an important decision about growing a mustache or using eyeshadow and mascara or wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead?
Look at that. The doctor said that he didn't jump. Did he tremble? No. Did he cry out? No. But why? Because there was no time. The snake slithered along his shoulder and coiled itself around his left arm above the elbow. And then what happened? The snake spread its hood and its head was just 3 or 4 inches from his face. Oh, this is so close. The doctor sat there holding his breath. He sat there like a stone image, like a lifeless body. Adeham oru karingal prathimayai. He did not move. But that was a good idea to remain still, or else the snake would attack him. Why did the doctor say that he was turned to stone? He sat still, holding his breath, and then he looked like a stone image. But his mind was active, which means he could think. And many thoughts sprang up in his mind. ഹി വാസ് ടെറിബിളി സ്കേർഡ്. ഭയം, താൻ ആകെ ജീവനുള്ള ഭയം മാത്രം. മരണം ചുറ്റിയിരിക്കുന്നു. ഹി ലുക്ക്ഡ് അറൗണ്ട് ആൻഡ് ഫൗണ്ട് എവറിത്തിങ് ഡാർക്ക്. പ്രതീക്ഷ കൈവിട്ടോ? വാസ് ഹി ലൂസിംഗ് ഹോപ്പ്? യെസ്, എവറിത്തിങ് ലുക്ക്ഡ് ഡാർക്ക് ഫോർ ഹിം. ദ ഡോർ ഓപ്പൺഡ് ഇൻ ടു ഡാർക്ക്നെസ്. ദ റൂം ഫിൽഡ് വിത്ത് ഡാർക്ക്നെസ്. ഹിസ് മൈൻഡ് ഫിൽഡ് വിത്ത് ഡാർക്ക്നെസ്. But then, a thought came up in his mind. The thought of the creator of this universe. Very good. What made the doctor think about God? He was so scared that he felt the great presence of the creator of this universe. ഇവിടെയാകുന്നു ലോകാലോകങ്ങളുടെ സൃഷ്ടാവിൻ്റെ മഹാസന്നിധി. ഈശ്വരൻ ഇവിടെയുണ്ട്. Suppose he said something and God did not like it. No, he did not want to take a chance. And in his imagination, outside his little heart, he wrote in bright letters the word, Oh God. A doctor has been sitting like a stone image for a long time. Let's take a look.
Oh God, is this snake made of molten fire? It's crushing my arm so much. It's hurting bad. I feel as though I have been wound by a thick leaden rod. It's so powerful. My muscles are getting drained out. I'm tired. If I moved my arm accidentally, the snake would strike for sure. A bite on the face means death. Oh no. And what would I do if I'm bitten? I have not stocked any medicines at home. Who would expect this to happen? Oh no. I'm so foolish. I'm such a stupid doctor.
See? Our doctor is in a pathetic state. There is pain in his left arm. The snake is slowly but powerfully crushing his arm. Kai aage kalachu thodangi. Why was the doctor experiencing pain in his arm? He was experiencing pain because the snake was crushing his arm. The doctor then compares the snake to two things because of the pain. What are they? What are the two things to which the doctor compares the snake? The snake is compared to a thick leaden rod, very good, and to a rod made of molten fire. Vannamulla oru eeya kambi alla teekattayal nirmicha oru kambi tande kai tandeyil balamayi murugunnathu pole. Oh, his arm was becoming weak. What to do now? Can he move his hand? No. Why can't the doctor move? He can't move because at the slightest movement, the snake would bite him. Anangyal kottu. Maranam naal inch dooratha. Death was lurking 4 inches away from him. Suppose the snake struck him. Did he have medicines at home? No, he did not have any medicines with him. And so now the doctor thinks of himself as a poor, stupid, and foolish doctor. Paavum, buddhihinanum, mandanumaya doctor. And that was a change of thought about himself. Earlier he thought of himself as a handsome young bachelor doctor. He forgot the danger for a moment and smiled feebly. Dayaniyamaya oru mandahasam. Now, what brought that feeble smile on the doctor's face? The thought that he was a poor, foolish, and stupid doctor made him smile feebly. Now, God appreciated that thought. The snake turned its head. Where is it looking now? Yes, into the mirror. The snake saw its reflection in the mirror. Kannadil paambu nokkunnundu. Two snakes look into a mirror? I am not sure. But this snake was looking into the mirror. For what? Dear children, let's get into the details of it in the next class. Now it's time for you to go through the text once again. If you come across a new word, underline it, try and guess the meaning from the context, or refer the glossary in page 39 or a dictionary.
I didn't jump. I didn't tremble. I didn't cry out. There was no time to do any such a thing. The snake slithered along my shoulder and coiled around my left arm above the elbow. The hood was spread out and its head was hardly 3 or 4 inches from my face. It would not be correct to say merely that I sat there holding my breath. I was turned to stone. But my mind was very active. The door opened into darkness. The room was filled with darkness. In the light of the lamp, I sat there like a stone image in the flesh. I felt then the great presence of the Creator of this world and this universe. God was there. Suppose I said something and He did not like it. I tried in my imagination to write in bright letters outside my little heart the words, "Oh God." There was some pain in my left arm. It was as if a thick leaden rod, no, a rod made of molten fire, was slowly but powerfully crushing my arm. The arm was beginning to be drained of all strength. What could I do? At my slightest movement, the snake would strike me. Death lurked 4 inches away. Suppose it struck. What was the medicine I had to take? There were no medicines in the room. I was but a poor, foolish, and stupid doctor. I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. It seemed as if God appreciated that. The snake turned its head. It looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. I do not claim that it was the first snake that had ever looked into a mirror, but it was certain that the snake was looking into the mirror. Was it admiring its own beauty? Was it trying to make an important decision about growing a mustache or using eyeshadow and mascara? Or wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead?
Now, dear children, this story is about a frightening incident narrated in a humorous way. Bayapeduthuna oru sambhavathe rasagaramayi avadhirippichirikkukayanu ee kadhayil. What makes it humorous? The writer has made use of striking contrast, vaibharithyam, opposite ideas, to bring about humor. Let's list them out. Kind of person the doctor was. Yes, a poor man. He had just started practice and you know his earnings were meager. Now, the kind of person he wanted to be? Yes, he wanted to be a rich and handsome doctor. That is why he says he wanted to marry a rich woman doctor who has a lot of practice. He wants to make his future safe. Okay? Now, second one, B. his thoughts when he looked into the mirror. He thought himself as a handsome, young, bachelor doctor. But then what happened to his thoughts when the snake coiled around his arm? He thought he was a poor, foolish, stupid doctor. It's these striking contrasts that bring about humor in the story. And now, here comes your assignment. Attempt a short paragraph on the use of contrast in the story to bring out the humor. Do the assignment and forward it to your teacher. And now, that marks the end of today's class. See you soon. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Take care.